I'm Dean Cifola, and this is the Azure Academy.
It's been said that lists help us in our lives in many different ways. They help to reduce anxiety because we've got things in order. They help to boost brain power, improve our focus, and even increase our self-esteem, if you can believe that, because you can cross things off your list that you've accomplished them. Well, today on the Azure Academy, I've got a list for you, and that is a list of the top 10 changes that have recently been made to the Azure portal. So as we kick off our top 10 list, please do click on the subscribe button and join us here at the Azure Academy community, and leave us a comment below on any questions that you have or a video that you'd like us to do in the future. There's still a lot out there we haven't covered from Ignite, and it's first come, first serve, so whatever you all ask for is what I'll create. So let's jump right over to the Azure portal. This would be kind of a fun video today as we look at all of the different changes to the portal experience that have happened in the last several weeks. Kicking it right off, we have the new home screen, and this has been changed from the previous home screen in now that we have resource services across the top. So this is your most recently accessed items, and there is a link right here for more services, which will take you to that same hamburger style menu that we had in the past, and we'll come back to this view in a moment. But we also have our recently used resources that now show up in a table view and a navigation structure here to help us kind of get around the portal. Now, one of the other big integrations to this home screen is Microsoft Learn. So Learn, in case you haven't checked it out yet, Learn is a place where you can follow learning paths. So if we click Browse All Paths here, then you can pick a role or product or level or type of thing that you're doing. For example, if we look at advanced administrator tasks, then these are all of the learning paths that fulfill that particular selection that I've made. So we can do that by looking at any one of these. So let's say here Dynamics 365, and then this will take us down the road of learning all about that, and we get a little overview and what's in each of these sections. You can jump to each section if you want to, or just follow the path right from the start. So there'll be a bunch of different stuff in here. There could be just text to read, pictures, videos, links to add some code into the interface to make sure that you've learned and understood things properly. So a great place to come and do some extra learning. So that's Microsoft Learn. And then along with that, we have other tools around managing the cloud. So these are kind of governance related. So we have Azure Monitor, Security Center, and Cost Management. And then down here at the bottom, some other useful links have been added. And then we have, of course, the mobile app, which we'll come back to a little bit later as well. So looking at our first link here, technical documentation, these are the Azure docs. So quick way to get to them right from the home screen. Migration tools would be Azure Migrate. And this page is a list of all of the Azure services, and there are quite a few. I think there's 156 services now. And then that Find an Expert, this is using Azure Lighthouse. Click the subscribe button if you want to see a video on Azure Lighthouse. We are preparing that and you don't want to miss that one. And we also have a link for all of the recent updates to Azure, including a link to set up your own RSS feed so you can get these on as they come out, and a link to the Azure Quick Start Center. We've spent a lot of time here in our governance series, and that's all to be found under the Azure Setup Guide, as well as a migration guide for how you can move into the cloud. And recently we've added an innovation guide, and this has to do with modernizing your workloads. And then of course there's some stuff down at the bottom for quickly deploying some other basic resources types that most people need a little help when they get started. And then we have that link for the Azure mobile app, and you can click on that to download it for iOS or Android, whatever your preferred platform is. So the focus of all of this is to keep the things that are relevant to you and what you are doing kind of front and center at all times. So along with that, we have new service cards. And this is something that if you hover over something like Azure Active Directory, you'll get a card here showing you that you can click on this to view this particular item, or go right to Microsoft Learn for some training, or go to our docs, getting started page, or pricing. And we can see that if we go over to virtual machines as well. We can create a VM from here or view our existing, a little description, some stuff around training at Microsoft Learn, as well as some useful links and even some free offerings in this case. So definitely something to check out in the new service cards. Now, going back to this hamburger menu, which we can also get to from more for services. This is the improved service experience. So we've also got all those cards in play here as well. So that's great. We don't lose that. And more Microsoft Learn links right here. So we are very invested in you learning more about Azure. And that's why this whole channel of the Azure Academy exists and why Microsoft Learn exists. And if you've got any questions about MS Learn or any comments, put them in the comment section below, and I'll make sure that those get over to our Learn team. We do work quite closely with them. So in this new experience, we've got our featured resources across the top, and these are the ones that most people use most often, but we still have that categorized view down the side, starting with all. And that's your traditional all services view that we've had in the portal for a while. And then you can click on each individual area. So you can see the general area at the top. And when I click on general, then that area is here, and then change it over to compute. You can see the compute resources, etc. So if we go back to the overview, that's our main services page. And again, a link right to the Quick Start Center from here, or the free services that are up in Azure, or find a link for those MSPs going back to the Azure Lighthouse. We've also improved the services view. And what I mean is anytime you click on a service like storage accounts, you've got a list of resources across all of the resource groups and subscriptions that you have permission to or are looking at in your global filter. And then if we take a look at the very long list of all of the Azure resources across all subscriptions that we have, you can see that there are 7 pages worth of resources. We can, of course, group these by resource type or by subscription, location, etc. That's been a feature for a while. But what we can also do now is we can also do an export to CSV, so we can take every resource that we have and just dump it out into a CSV file. Then we can sort that and organize it and format it, and that'll give us everything from the resources to the very extended tags that are possible. And of course, you can filter on this and sort and organize and do whatever you would like with it. And a piece of continuous improvement that's going on across Azure are the individual resource creation experiences. So for example, if we go to create a new virtual machine, then this experience has been updated for quite a while now. And you've got a tabbed experience across the top here, where you can just select and build out what it is that you need to. Some other resources are not quite up to date with that yet. For example, we go to create a virtual network. We can see that this is still the old experience. So these things are going to be updated over time. And pretty soon your portals will be updated so that your virtual network creation experience looks something like this. Okay, and then you'll have a tabbed experience, which will make setting things up for your network quite a bit easier. The next one that we'll look at, we'll put in the search bar here. It's the Resource Graph Explorer. So Resource Graph is a tool that we haven't really covered on the Azure Academy, but basically everything that powers the screens that have lots of information on them are powered on the back end by the Resource Graph. It's a way to query the APIs more directly and then surface that information to you in a nicer format. So for example, if we go to our all services, what you're looking at here, why it populates across the 30 subscriptions that I have access to with 7 pages worth of resources that fast is thanks to the Resource Graph. So the Resource Graph Explorer will help us to write our queries against all of the resources that we have across Azure, and that way we can do some investigative work on what's going on. And that's been around for a little while, but now we've also got Resource Graph Queries. So we can open the Graph Explorer from here. This is a place where all of your queries that you write will be saved and then can be reused. So if we go back to the Explorer here and we write ourselves a query. So if we do something to give us a count of all of our resources, and then we run that query, we can see that we've got 752 resources, or we can get a little bit more specific, say with something like how many key vaults do I have? There we go, 17 different key vaults. Or I could take out the count, and it will give me all of the 17 assets across all the different subscriptions that I have access to. Okay, so the resource graph is definitely a cool thing to learn if you don't know it already. And the resource graph is written against the Cousteau language. So if we take this query and we save this, now we can choose to save it as a private query or as a shared query. So I'll save it shared. And then we have an option to create a resource graph queries resource group, or we could uncheck it and use an existing group. Like I'll use my Azure Management group for this, and we'll hit save. And there's our resource graph query. So now if we go back to our resource graph queries space, we can see there is our query as well. The next thing on our list is going to be dashboards. Now I know you've seen dashboards before, and let me resize this. So this is a very complex dashboard, and actually this comes out of the Azure Sentinel. It's a built-in dashboard from there. And if you missed our Sentinel video, you can check that out in the card up here. The thing about dashboards is not necessarily what we put on them or the tables or anything. The feature update here is that dashboards now automatically refresh over some time intervals. So if we zoom back in so you can read everything, we see here we have an auto refresh every hour. And this can be changed to a couple hours or every day, turn it off, or update every 30 minutes. So that'll help your dashboards to automatically stay up to date instead of having to periodically go in and click the refresh button. And that also brings me to some of the updated icons that we have. In case you didn't notice, the icons have been recently refreshed and now made publicly everywhere. So everything in Azure is getting a facelift and modernizing a little more. The idea here is that we have better visual contrast in our icons and that they're more distinct from one another. So if you have some comments about that, give us any feedback either down below, or you can press the feedback icon up here. So we're always looking for getting your feedback, and this particular new feature of removing the sidebar did cause some people quite a panic, and they weren't sure where it went or what to do or how to get it back. And then we had the feature there, but it was somewhat hidden, so I want to show it to you so that you can see it. So right now I've got a sidebar, and if I go to settings, I can choose to make the default mode for the portal to fly out or be docked, and that's referring to this sidebar. So if I change it to fly out, you can see my bar goes away. The benefit of that is it gives you a little more screen real estate. You're a little more focused in the particular area of the portal that you're looking at, but that menu is still available here under the hamburger. So you can get to that. You can get to all services in the same way. Not really a big deal in my case, although I definitely did prefer the docked view. So I'll put my sidebar back there. And of course, the other thing is that we do have, in case you weren't familiar, several different portal settings here where you can have the portal automatically sign you out after a certain duration, as well as changing your default view from the home screen to a dashboard. And then, of course, changing your theme in many different ways. I prefer dark theme because I'm staring at my screen all day long. But you can also choose high contrast themes, either light or dark, whatever your preference is for that. Language and region support have now been added into the portal. So if you prefer a different language, then you can by all means set that up directly in the Azure portal, regardless of what your other system settings are. And you can also change your regional format from being English United States to perhaps English United Kingdom. And of course, you can change these things as many times as you like to find what works best for you. And so now we're going to take a look at the Azure mobile app. And when I start my mobile app, I've got it set for multi-factor authentication. So I'll use my fingerprint ID there. And so the mobile app has had a redesign as well. So we've got our updated icons and new home screen. And you can click on the hamburger menu here at the top. And that'll show you the different Azure ADs that you have access to, as well as different identities that you can log on with. Then we have our settings. And you can choose anything from customizing the home experience, which things you want on that screen and which you do not, to allowing push notifications, require Touch ID, multiple subscription mode, and there's even a welcome tour here if you haven't seen that. That'll just walk you through the experience, and you can slide right through to see all that you can do in the portal app. Then back in the app itself, we've got an edit button here at the top, and that'll take you to that same editing of the home screen menu, as well as there is the filter button, and the filter allows you to select which subscriptions you're looking at. And I'm just looking at my two main subscriptions here. And then at the very bottom, we've got all of our home subscription resources, notifications, and a cloud shell. So if I click on the cloud shell here, then we get a neat little animation while it spins up my Cloud Shell instance. And there we go. We have a Cloud Shell. So now if I bring up my keyboard here, I can type my AZ command. And there we've got everything that we need. So this is a bash shell. And if I turn my phone sideways, so I'll just put in a command to get all my tags. So this just gives me the total count of tags across all of my subscriptions. Fully integrated Cloud Shell here, and you could even switch it over to PowerShell if you want to, but we'll save that for another video. So back in the main screen of our app here, we could go to our subscriptions and dig into each one of them and see the different resource groups that are present, or we could even go to a particular kind of resource here. So I've got it set on virtual machines, but in the top right, I can hit the filter and then change this from the type that I'm looking at to include all types or just a select type, and then hit the check mark. That'll change my view then, so I could look at my Bastion service if I want to, or look at my storage account or whatever else I'm interested in. And there's also notifications that are here, which would be service health as well as alerts. Thankfully, no service health alerts right now. So I can do a lot of management from the mobile app, as you can see. And so we've improved this experience quite a lot. So I hope you've enjoyed looking at the top things that have changed recently across the Azure portal and the Azure mobile app. And all of this experience has been driven by your feedback, so please keep your feedback coming. And if you haven't done so already, join us here at the Azure Academy community and click that subscribe button. And click the like button if you thought that this was a good video. And if you want to get an email when our videos come out, which is roughly once a week, you can click on that notification bell. And don't forget to leave us some comments down below. We do love your feedback, and please keep it coming. We'll see you in the next one. Happy learning.